Wow, that is my one-word explanation of what it was like to be on the streets of Harare as the news broke that the reviled President Robert Mugabe had resigned. But it deserves more. It was as if people couldn't contain their joy and relief. Attempting to interview them quickly descended into raucous singing. Sweat glistened on the twitching torsos of the dancing revelers, and all of it was accompanied by the spray of beer and whiff of marijuana in the air. There were thousands out there, some in smart city suits, others less well turned out, but all to a man and woman were ecstatic, and it was catching video. I nearly collapsed through excitement. Profile: assassination attempts, power grabs and tyranny. What next for Zimbabwe's crippled economy? I found myself grinning for most of the time I was trying to get myself heard on air. I have appeared in more selfies with strangers in a few hours in downtown Harare than in my entire life to date. Everyone wanted a memento of the night their lives changed, hopey forever. SOLRs were lifted up, looking vaguely bemused. Everyone was good-natured, there was not a hint of menace. Video: Johnson, Zimbabwe's moment of hope. I have beaten Christ Mugabe. In his own words, Zimbabwe's next president, who is the crocodile. We were introduced to a four-month-old baby, whose parents had presidential ambitions for him, and a couple of young women who seemed to think the demise of Mugabe would lead directly to marriage proposals. Intoxicating stuff, this toppling of despots. Whatever happens next, I'll never forget. I was there the day Zimbabwe broke free from Mugabe. It was a thrill.